right? It's literally like your mobile phone, right? You take it out of the box, and it works perfectly well for the first day, right? So the battery lasts a full day, only that first day, right? And then what happens is you start to install weird apps on it. And that's really, truly what happens to us as children. They start
especially
to
San Francisco, we install lots of weird apps.
I mean, I love you guys, but it's, no, but it's like really, the more Western we become, the more influenced we are by the illusions of the modern world. And those illusions include things like the shape of your body matters, the way people think about you matters, you know, that success is measured in material possessions, that this is the only way to measure success. And by the way, it doesn't matter how much you have. What matters is that you have more than your neighbor, right? You don't have to score an A, you have to score an A better than your sister, right? And you know, it's like, why? Like, seriously, I mean, my wonderful son Ali came to me at a point in time and I said, Ali, you should score an A in mathematics, you're good in mathematics. And he said, Papa, why? Why do you want me to score an A? I said, because you're good at it. And he went like, yeah, but why is an A important? If I'm good at it, why do you want an A, right? And I struggled a little bit and he said, okay, let me help you here. Do you want me to learn math and be amazing at it and score a B? Mm. Or do you want me to not learn math and score an A? Which of those is better for you?
Good question.
Great question. And I was like, yeah, why do I care so much about a mold that they put us in, while the reality is all I want is that my son learns mathematics, right? And by the way, I didn't want him to learn geography, even though every parent will say, hey, you know, you need to score an A in everything. Too much. And take that and understand how we treat our children, right? They're born happy, they stay happy until we mess up, right? We send them to school and we say, hey, you remember that playful, joyful thing? No more, right? 6 hours a day, we want you to sit in this place, don't open your mouth, whatever junk the teacher says, nod and say yes, right? If you believe that what the teacher is telling you is not right, don't object, because that's not a good way to score, right, to get an A. And what do? Everyone, some of us resist and we're rebellious and we take a few weeks of saying, no, I still wanna play, right? And then we all submit and we all go like, yeah, who wants to play? It's like, it's causing me too much trouble. Who wants to be, you know, playful? Who wants to be fun? Let's just get serious. Serious? You're six. Like, where did that come from, right? And we take that and we follow through the rest of our lives. One of my most eye-opening experiences when I joined Google, you know, was that 10 things we knew to be true. One of them was you can be serious without a suit, right? Mm-hmm. And there is a very interesting difference between serious or grumpy, if you want, and committed. They're not one and the same. Somehow people said, hey, you need to be serious. Yeah. Does serious equal grumpy or does serious equal committed? Right? I'm committed, I can show up at work and put my heart in it, but smile and hug my team and, you know, we have a good time and we have fun and we love it. Isn't that better than just going out there and going, do your work? Who was that? We're all little children inside.
Yes, and Pablo Picasso talked about the importance of retaining a childhood throughout the rest of your life.
Believe it or not.